The monkey that refused to eat banana would dance to the dribbling dance of plantain. The house help that likes to dress more than the madam will end up back in the village where she came from. Any ram that refuses to fight street challenge will end up on top of jollof rice on Salah Day. Any girl that prefers to be a side chick rather than to be a wife will end up being a sugar mommy. He that makes procrastination as his best friend will end up in the headquarters of delay and failure. If an Agbero is learning to wear suit, then you know that he is about to be given the position of head of talks and director. Anybody that wants to smoke more than Naira Marley will end up in Yaba Left. The lizard that pursues cockroach into the hole will end up in the belly of the snake. A child that runs after biscuit will end up in the den of kidnappers. The Agama lizard without the red head has lost the glory of his crown. They say food for thought, food for thought. Me have been thinking since yesterday. Nobody has given me any food. Which one is food for thought? They say a patient man will eat ripe fruit. Some people say a patient dog will eat the fattest bone. My grandpa has been patiently waiting for Nigeria to get better since he was born. He has gray hair now. He has not eaten anything, no, not to talk of fat bone. They say if you want to go quick, go alone. With ritualists everywhere in December month, who will agree to go alone? Me, I can't go alone, no. They say a friend in need is a friend indeed. That one now has made Uncle Toy to be coming to our house every day to eat food. Now wow. A calabash that refuses to hold palm wine will end up holding charm for the native doctor. They say a good man is hard to find. That is true, because good people always die on time. So me, I'm making my New Year resolution. I don't want to die on time, so me, I can't be a good man when I grow up. They say for the benefit of doubt. How can doubt have benefit? Has anyone ever benefited from people doubting you? They say a journey of 1,000 miles will begin with one footstep. Who wants to walk that kind of journey? Is it me? 1,000 miles? Ha! Me, I cannot do that too. When Okada and Tweke Tweke Moto are everywhere, I will even enter Keke Sef. Like when I used to travel with my uncle, like I was describing to Twi Twi yesterday when she was asking me road to California. Ah, it is very easy and cheap, Sef. For the sake of those of you who have been trying to travel out of Nigeria and have not been able to do so, I will help to give you tips in case California is a place that you love to travel to. Just enter plane from Oshodiona Bridge there. As you are entering the plane like this, please remember to tell the pilot where you are going, so that they will not carry you and pass. Because sometimes the pilot will stop at Kuwait to put fuel and some people will want to buy food there. Now listen carefully, Once the pilot stops like this at Kuwait, to minimize your transportation cost, just come down and behave as if you want to buy food. Then you can't wait there till evening and take night bus to California. But if you don't want to follow night bus, just enter Keke from there to Sao Tome. Once you reach Sao Tome like this at Ariaria Junction, take a bike 100 naira, bagam, you have entered California. Very, very easy. By next week, I will tell you people how to go to Canada. You know that those of us that have been traveling a lot, we know the road very much and we know the cheapest way to get to anywhere. Back to my proverbs. Any man that bleaches too much will turn out to be the conjugal affiliate of Bob Risky. The chicken that walks alone will end up in the tummy of the cat as late afternoon dinner. On the street of by and by, you will get to the house of Mr. Nowhere. Wait, let me expatiate on this matter. That one means, for those of you that keep saying, by so-so-so-so time, I will do this. By so-so-so-so month, I will do that. It means that you will keep saying by this, by that, I will do this, I will do that, until procrastination will consume you and you will go nowhere. So, on the street of by and by, you will get to the house of Mr. Nowhere. That is why Nigeria is the way it is, Because during the reign of Yaradua, we had Vision 2020. This is 2020 today, and we are worse than when we made the vision. Let us continue proverbially. They say leopard cannot change its spots. It's a lie. In Nigeria, Adams Oshiomhole used to be the one that used to fight government whenever government does not meet the demand of the people, or especially during the time they used to increase fuel price. Today, Adams Oshiomhole has become the supporting backbone of the people that are terrorizing the citizens. So a Nigerian leopard can always change its spots. You people should correct that proverb. They say a problem shared is half solved. Please, listen carefully. This is my problem. I need 10,000 naira to buy my Christmas clothes. I have shared my problem with you, Abi. Say if I go to the boutique now, the price of the clothes will now slash by 5,000. There are some proverbs that are not meant for those of us in Nigeria. That is why I am giving you my own proverbs today. A musician that wants to compete with Wizkid and Two-Face will end up feeding a village of children. A child that does not listen to the advice of the parent will suffer the effect of the brutality of a bad gang. The chicken that walks anyhow during Christmas will end up in the pot of stew. A girl that runs after money will end up as sacrifice for Yahoo boys. He that runs after bleaching cream will end up competing his fingers with roasted plantain. Drop your own proverb in the comment section, because me, I have not eaten since morning. I am tired like this. My wicked uncle did not give me food just because he said one piece of meat is lost from the pot of soup. Imagine that. Then he said there is no food for anybody until they provide the piece of meat. Which kind of wickedness is this one? Say if you lost something, you report to the police for investigation. Eh? See me, see wahala. That is why he did not prepare for the show today, because he is looking for just one piece of meat. Now wow, it is a plantainous matter. See you people next week. Please, if you are watching on Facebook, like our page. If you are watching on YouTube, endeavor to subscribe. Don't forget to share and leave a comment. We post new episodes every weekend. So always look up this space for new content every goddamn week. Say that English is correct, Abi. A patois. Me, I am a grammatologist. Love you all and see you next week.